Hey, we're at the Green Malt Barley Days Parade here today. We're on Facebook Live. You're seeing us there. You're seeing us on YouTube a little bit later. We're going to be testing the whole parade. It's starting right now. We've got Stearns County Sheriff leading the parade with the colors being brought through. Pretty powerful float. You'll have to check the YouTube video out to see the full effect of that float. They did a really nice job with that. But this was Green Malt. Well, you can hear taps in the background. It was Green Malt Barley Days this weekend, August 6th and 7th, the first weekend in August. Let's see, what do they got coming up today? Today they got noon to 4, Stone Road going on today. Themed superheroes, that's what the parade is today. My superheroes, yeah, it's their theme for today. Melrose Ambulance, looks like it's sponsored by Kramer Lumber in Melrose. If you haven't gotten a chance to check that out, you need to stop there. A great little lumberyard that has become a hardware store, True Value Hardware Store, and they have got more things there than you can shake a stick at. So, small town lumber store, hardware store. You want to stop and check that out because doing business with the local businesses is hugely important. Another ambulance from the Melrose Area Ambulance Service. We're gonna plug a microphone into the live stream, so bear with me here. It's gonna get weird and noisy for a second. That way you guys can hear me a little bit better. It's gonna get shaky too. Sorry about this. Now, if you're watching the live stream and you can hear me, please let me know in the chat. Just go in there and let me know if you can hear me. Well, Melrose Fire Truck coming through next. If you're watching nightly, the Facebook live stream, please let me know if the microphone is working, because I can't test it when we're live like this. That'll clear out your ears right there. Fire truck coming through here from Melrose Fire Department with their mascot up on top. You guys can see that. They've got their superhero puppy dog, the Dalmatian. TV there from the Melrose Fire Department. We're in Greenwald today, August 7th, 2016. If you're watching on the live stream and you can hear me, please put it in the comments that yes, I can hear you. That would be awesome. I can't tell if the microphone's working or not, so they might be getting a really quiet video. Those watching that are from outside of our area, Greenwald is just south of Melrose, about 8 to 10 miles. Melrose is in central Minnesota. The reason I say that, for those of you who are local, is that we have people watching from around the world watching these videos. It's kind of cool. And we have comments coming in from around the world who are checking out small town Minnesota on our videos. So thank you for everyone who is watching these, whether you're watching on Facebook or YouTube. Thank you very much for doing that. If you like these types of videos, please click the thumbs up or the like button. We sure appreciate that. That gives us some feedback that these types of videos are something you guys want to see us continue to do. These have been working pretty well, and we're hoping to continue this into 2017. All right, thank you. Thank you very much for the comment on the microphone. I want to make sure. Grand Marshal is Jim and Bonnie Schultzenberg right there. Thank you. They are going on through. And it looks like we've got, coming the other direction, there must be another group of beverage folks coming through here. The cattle tank, they've got the Massey Ferguson riding lawnmower garden tractor, it's really not, it doesn't have a lawnmower attachment, on a flatbed trailer there. Yeah, those guys are, they're serious. They're gonna sell some water. Next, coming up on our screens here in just a second, is the St. John St. Andrews School. This is the part of the state where they can still have some small local schools in the Catholic Church in both communities. They're very, very supportive, and they have a private school up on the truck there waving away. Kids throwing out the candy. That is a Ranger F100 right there. These are want to find out more about that truck, how old that is. It's an early Ranger right there for you. And who do we have? Freeport State Bank, I believe is what we have coming next. Sponsoring some live music. A little old-time music coming at us. In Melrose, Freeport, New Munich, and in town here in Greenwood. sure which one, who is coming up next. But we are listening to Heaven, There Is No Beer. Notch Manufacturing out of Painesville. There we go. You're going to be putting up a float in a parade. Make it easier for folks down to identify you by putting your name in the front also. Otherwise, we have no idea who you are until you're beyond. They have got some serious rock wagons there. Take a look at those as they go by. That is some serious rock buckets and wagons there. Look at that. Wow. Big stuff there. Big stuff. Superheroes David and Clara, is that what I'm seeing, from Padua Pub?
I just gave him my
handle. Right there. There we go.
I can't hear my name, but I don't know where it's
coming from. And they're dressed up as superheroes. Little flares. Rays are going by with little guys. One cool thing about parades in central Minnesota is if you have children, generally you're going to end up with candy. If you like candy or not, you're going to end up with candy. For those of you who've never really been to much for parades, it's something that most floats are throwing candy out, whether it's Tootsie Rolls or I see suckers and different licorices, small candy bars. I mean, there's all sorts of things being tossed out. I'm waiting for one of these superheroes to throw out like a Green Lantern ring that really works. That'd be pretty cool. I see Hulk, Superman, Iron Man. Not sure what the two on top are. We'll have to see. Yeah, there's Spider-Man. Yeah, on the back. Greenwald Elevators, the truck. Oh, Hillary and Donald. Ah, Hillary and Donald up on top of the truck. That's who that is. We'll turn the camera so the YouTube one can get a better view of what they're doing up there. Oh yes, right there. Hillary, Donald, Michelle, and Barack, right there. So we can say that this is the first parade that we've had the past president, or the current president, and the future president at the parade. That's pretty impressive in Greenwald, Minnesota. Genex Farm Systems is the next truck coming through. Are the ones who do those, the harvester. Those are the kind of like silos, but the blue ones. And they also do the slurry store, which is how farmers in the area, if you are not in that, that's where they're going to be able to get the manure from their barn is held in place like that. Be able to get it cleaned up and out. Another drink thing just went by, a little Kubota. I'll tell you what, that sounds smooth. It must be a little diesel in that. So we're going to get to compare riding lawnmowers today, it sounds like. Although that looks more like a hydrostatic tractor there. We're in Greenwald, Minnesota at the Barley Days Parade. They've got a weekend. This is their Barley Days weekend with activities both Saturday and Sunday. They had a polka mass last night, it looked like. And this afternoon, I think from noon until 4, they've got a band that's playing down here. So it's a big weekend. A lot of folks turn out for this parade. Basically, it pulls folks from all over central Stearns County for this parade. If you're watching this on Facebook Live, thank you for watching. If you're watching this later on YouTube, you can check out, you'll see a little bit more in that video, just because it's a wider video, and also we can kind of turn the camera a little bit easier than we can on the Facebook Live. If you happen to be watching this on the third video on the Mevo, well, that meant it worked. We're trying out a new camera during this parade today, so I'm not going to guarantee that one's going to work because it is an experimental camera that is literally just was released a few days ago. So, and there's our Stearns County Sheriff walking by right there. Coming through. person right there on your screen right now, coming on through. Local representative for District 12B, which is the area that we are in right now. Hopefully Paul's got his Fitbit on so he can be keeping track of his steps today. He'll do well with that. Camera right now. I believe it's Tori Westrum, state senator from our area here. Cities, you're used to fire departments with the nice trucks and nice vehicles and all the tools they need. It's really kind of neat that in our small town, these fire departments, the community has supported them where they can go and get quality firefighting tools. Just making life out here is a little bit safer for those of us who live out in the rural part of Minnesota. So very cool to see Lake Henry, a very small community, but a very nice looking modern fire truck there that can get out there and hopefully save lives and save property. I'm guessing this is our gymnast here from Melrose. There they are, right there. Coming on through. Yeah, let's see, they've got a color run going on August 19th at Dutchman Plaza at the school. There's a 1K that kicks off at 6:45 p.m. and a 5K at 8:15. And if this is a color run, what I believe it is that at one point in time you're going to get doused with color powder. So you wear a white shirt, you run through, and you become powdered and colored. Kids love it. Us old people, not so much. You know, you're going to mess up my hair. I'm going to have to run and sweat. What if they have a 1K walk? Then I could hatch a poke egg. This would be great. State Farm, right there. Donna, where is she out there? Oh, we've got we're hearing superhero. We have another superhero quote coming up here. Let's see if we can see who this is. A Green Lantern hat. We've got the Greenwald girl. Spider-Man. The Greenwald girl is here to protect us and save us all. Right here. We're good right now.
Help.
We're safe because you're here. Thank you. Look at the bad guys in the jail. Herbie's Heroes. ever seen one. If you want to see that float, you're going to have to watch the YouTube video, gang. We got a nice panel on that. And yes, the Greenwald girl is here, so we are safe. Just saying. I was feeling kind of, yes, I saw the Stearns County Sheriff go by, but now I feel safe because Greenwald girl was here. CHS? Am I seeing that right? Let's see, we have another crew. Oh, we've got the Incredibles coming through. This is awesome.
Hey, best looking princesses around all day.
Nice.
Hey.
They dressed for this Painesville, young ladies from Painesville. Nice job, ladies. I like that. That is very, very cool. The Incredibles right here coming through the Barley Day Parade right there. Nice stuff. Good stuff. Of course, now they've got their Halloween costumes already picked out.
Yeah, exactly.
You're done. We got a better scan of that, their costumes and such on YouTube. You can check those out. Let's see, who do we have coming through? Greenwald Insurance Agency right there. It's no joke, call us for a quote right there. And it must be Batman and Joker right there.
Joker!
And there we go. It's kind of fun when you've got quotes and groups that kind of dressed to the theme and such. Having a theme at a parade is neat when folks do that. We've seen some parades where they have a theme, but like one or two and that's it. So it's really, really kind of neat and refreshing when you have groups of businesses and such that will do that. John Weiss Ford, out of Sauk Center. One of the biggest Ford dealerships here in the central part of the state. Looks like the Taekwondo crew is coming on down the road here. We are in Greenwald right now. Barley Day, it's a beautiful day. Sunshine, no breeze. Humidity's not too, this is a nice day today. Very, very nice. We're out here enjoying the parade, and then about noon or so, they're gonna kick off with some entertainment on down by the school, I'm guessing, is where they're gonna do that. Down by the school and church and the grounds there. Looks like our Facebook stream is having a little issue with connecting here. I see it bounced out for a second. I apologize for that. You guys will be able to see the full video on YouTube. And maybe it'll happen just at the right time where you won't miss much. Lakes Area Taekwondo, great thing to get your kids involved with. They can do this if they're not out for organized sports. They can come and be involved with something, get a little exercise, learn some self-protection skills, self-defense skills. Great thing for your children in winter time, fall, winter time, when they need to do something. Taekwondo is definitely not. Oh, and the little guy just did a demonstration breaking the board. Yeah. Colin Peterson right up there, and Russ Hinrich. Hello, guys. Hello. Coming through the parade. I don't see Colin down this way too often, so it's nice to see him making it down here. Looks like we got a little bit of a break in the parade. There's gonna be some more live stream activities going on. more events that we're going to be covering here this fall. If you keep an eye on the Hometown News, you can go to hometownnews.biz and you'll be able to find out what we have for coming upcoming activities that we'll be covering, different community events, parades, what have you. Live streaming seems to be pretty popular and folks have been really enjoying that, so we're going to try to continue to bring you that. And this is bad. I'm going to be somewhere Saturday. I don't remember where, but I think there was something we're going to be bringing you next Saturday, and I didn't look that far ahead of my schedule because some of you may know I'm a wedding entertainer, and I had a late night wedding last night, so I just looked at the schedule this morning, or I had it pointed out to me that, hey, there's a parade at 11, so here I am. So, but just keep an eye on the hometownnews.biz or pick one up at one of the local stores that have those in our communities, and you can check out where the parades are and things next weekend, and that's where you will find me on Saturday, or, well, myself or Lori. Last night we were in Albany, getting some footage of that. We'll get that up a little bit later today. Ron's Oil and Propane. Are some of the filling stations around the area. And of course, they can handle your propane tank. If you do not have natural gas, they are the ones to give a call. That's Ron's Oil and Propane. The little muscle dude, you see him in the ads. That is their guy. See, our Ron's Oil and Propane, right here, out of Melrose.
In case you guys haven't seen it, this is what they're throwing.
Little koozies. I can even take my bottle of tea and put it in there. That's how good. More live music. Sponsored by Grove Mutual Fire Insurance, let's see, Greenwell Farm Center, Kramer Lumber, Ray's Service, Schneider, I can't see it, and Meyer Grove Co-op. A lot of area businesses here are sponsoring that. That is a band of folks from around the area here. I recognize some from up in Gray Eagle. You saw one gentleman waving. They obviously have seen me at parades before and know what I'm doing, so good stuff here. But that's community band. It's always cool to see live music going through the parades, even if it's not the kids marching through. Sometimes being on the big trailer like that is really kind of a cool thing, so live music. And again, I'm talking as a DJ, but it's still neat to see the live music. We're at the Barley Days Parade here, August 7th, 2016. You're watching us maybe live on Facebook because we live stream a lot of area events. It's a little bit smaller video. If you want to see the full version or the wider video where we're actually able to pan with some of the floats, you can check that out on YouTube. Darrell Lane, a 1971 Lincoln right there, Lincoln Continental. But yeah, you can keep an eye on the Hometown News. I know there's activities going on here throughout August. There are going to be some community celebrations, and we get into the fall schedule where we get into Bertram with their heritage days. Their, we'll call it a threshing, woodwork, or wood sawing, whatever. And then you've got Albany. I mean, there's just lots of things going on here this fall. Watch the Hometown News. You'll be able to see what's coming up. Check out some of these activities. Some of these things are just incredible slices of Americana that you do not see anywhere else. Central Minnesota Credit Union with offices everywhere. Basically, if you turn around, there's a credit union office, which is very convenient for those of us who do a lot of business and do a lot of banking and such and online things. It's all there. You can check that out. Central Minnesota Credit Union. A they have got the Tootsie Rolls. And they're not handing them out one or two at a time. It is handful. And they have waves of staff coming through. Two bags. That is a serious man.
Yep.
Let's see, whose truck is this? Who's got the pretty Chevy? Stearns County Dairy Princess is right there. Coming through. Again, it would be nice to have something on the front so we could talk about them before they're past us. Had a covered wagon coming through. Looks like being pulled by a couple of mules there. Hello, hello. A draft horse and field day. I don't know when it was. Right there. Did you see it? Give me a sec. I'm not sure when it is. It's just a little tiny 8x8.5x11 sign on there. It's a draft horse and field day. Hopefully they'll let us know at the hometown news of what and when. That'd be kind of fun to go out and see some big old draft horses. I mean, I'd be old, but they're big. Much bigger than me. I'm a pretty tall person. But I don't weigh 2,000 pounds. A couple of tractors coming up here. Like an older International leading the way. But not a really old one, just an older one. Restoring that one. Paint looks good. If you like old tractors, coming up in September, you got to check that out. It's a Albany Pioneer Days. Tractors, and more tractors. Could there be 200 tractors? Maybe. It's just crazy the amount of tractors that are at the Pioneer Days. Depends on the weather. If you had great weather like we have today, if it could be a weekend like this, yeah, you'll have got it. We've got a turbo Farmo coming through here. It's a 1206. And we've got Spider-Man in the back. This is got Greenwald Farm Center right there. Big Ron Reagan. You know, when you're Spider-Man, you really can't hide that, you know. This Spider-Man's in really good shape, but I couldn't wear a Spider-Man costume. I'm thinking that I would be too revealing with that I'm over 40. Maybe I'm sharing too much here today on our video, but that's okay. It's Barley Days Parade, and we can talk about pretty much whatever we want to. Young's Veterinary Service. Where are they out of? Serving the dairy industry. I do not know. Huh. So you learn something every day. No relation to me. company Chrysler truck is pulling what? Got a soda trailer giveaway. Chasm Radio. I think he's just got the radio on load. Not that that's a big deal, but I think that that's... Oh, it looks like they are doing a raffle. A couple of ladies are walking down the street selling chances for quilts. And that's one of the coolest things with these small town activities, is where they have different, you can, you know, baked goods, you can pick up some baked goods and different things there, and they've got these quilt raffles. And I've mentioned this in other videos. Freeport has this, they'll have it today, where you can go and buy chances to buy some of these handmade quilts. A Rose of Fire is next, Fire and Rescue. But buying, you need to throw farther! She tried, she got him close. Truck coming down the road. Hoping we can get that young lady to show us the quilt a little bit more. But these are handmade quilts that you're going to be finding at these different community activities. The ladies from the churches and such make these. My grandmother from the Spring Hill area, they used to have their getting together and doing their quilting on a regular basis, making quilts for the different activities and different fundraisers. So can you bring that over here? I've been talking about the quilt raffle, so I wanted to show one. So if you could stand like right where that piece of candy is, I think, yeah, there we go. That is one of the quilts right there at the quilt raffle. Thank you. Beautiful handmade quilts that you can go. Farmers Insurance, Mary Olmscheid just went by. Yeah, that's one of them. You guys are going to be doing that down at the...
Nope. Oh. Just
as you're walking down.
Yeah,
okay.
Yep. We'll draw right after the parade.
Right after the parade. So this is a parade quilt. The raffle just going on during the parade. That's kind of cool. So when they're done, when they get to the end of the parade, they draw, give you a call and say, hey, you won. Of course, if you're watching this, then you guys are not able to be possible. You're part of that. But it's still kind of a neat thing. My candy crew pick up and clean up the street, because part of parades is making... You missed one right there, this blue one. Get that one. Is keeping everything clean, because we don't want to leave wrappers and candy that's gotten smushed. We pick everything up and then we clean it up and throw what we need to in the garbage so that it doesn't look like we were even here. That's what parades should be about. It was Duck Center ambulance that just went by the way. Sorry, I was too busy talking about that. I want to say this is the... Is this the Bertram crew? No. They make it all the way down here? They did. Minnesota Heritage Club out of Bertram, August 27th and 28th. This is one of those activities you need to check out. We're going to turn the camera a little bit so YouTube people can see. They've got old engines there, they've got steam stuff, they're threshing, they've got wood things, they've got tractors, not as many as Pioneer Days, but it's out in the middle of this field, north of Bertram. And they've got this cool little grounds, and they do weird activities, weird games, weird things for, you know, when you have a tractor race, you know, you think it would be like, you know, trying to go forward fast. Well, their version is a pushing the tractor race. It's just a different time. So you got to check that out. That's August 27th and 28th in Bertram, Minnesota. Got an old engine there being pulled along. Ice cream machine that was on that trailer, so you'll have to rewind the video. Grandpa David's ice cream machine, powered by a 1.5 horse John Deere engine. A single cylinder engine, hop, hop as it fires. Big flywheel on that thing. There's that little Kubota coming through again. It would be about 10 degrees warmer, they'd be selling water left and right. Worms Ready Mix coming through next.
Coming on your screen right about now. There we are.
They've got offices in, let's see, New Munich. They're down there. I believe they're over in Sauk Center. And are they up in Long Prairie too? Yep, they are. Basically, if you need cement, concrete, color concrete, a variety of different things, they can do it for you. We actually had some work done where we needed to have some unusual things added to the concrete. They've got it there and they can do it for us. It turned out wonderfully. They've got the old Batman cartoon things up there. Melrose Bowl Bar and Shift's Bar and Grill, right? Just a little bit to the east of in Melrose there.
How dare you cut!
What's up?
There we go.
They're dressed up as a bowling ball and a bowling pin. What do we have next here? Smoking Joe's Welding. Oh, those are kind of cool chairs there. You can put that on the YouTube video. You guys can check that out. Making some neat little tables and chairs there. Very neat. And we've got some horses. Neatfeld Seed. Coming through here. Nice, nice looking horses. What do we have here? We got a Polaris Ranger. Extra Innings Bar and Grill in Spring Hill. Their Wellies in Spring Hill. Minneapolis Marine coming through right now. What of a year on that. Let's see, Bruton Royalty, Miss Bruton Royalty is coming up next. Oh, and young lady's got a cape there for her superhero costume. Royalty from Miss Bruton. We got Wheels Well Drilling coming up next.
Yep.
Wheels Water Service at Melrose. You can give them a call. They can handle a lot of your, when the well is down. This is the drilling truck right here. We just saw it comes through. When the well is dry, that's a welcome sight. See that rolling down your driveway. So is this a fourth group of princesses? Could be. This would be the princess parade. Where are these gals from? Miss Melrose, okay. Miss Melrose going through there. And then little Miss Melrose coming behind that. And we're gonna have to pan the camera. Or pan the other camera. Oh, they're throwing glitter and it doesn't go very far. They're trying to throw confetti. Throwing a little confetti. Arnold's is coming up next. Arnold's is one of the larger equipment dealers in the area. Those of you out of the area, used to be there was equipment dealers in most of the towns way back in the day. A lot of these small communities had equipment dealers, multiple equipment dealers in some of these small towns with 500 people. I guess it was such a big thing, but not to be any nowadays. So Arnold's is one of the biggest, and they do a great job down in St. Martin area. You can check that out. Sounds like an Alice Chalmer. Kind of looks like an Alice Chalmer. Let's see what it is. It's an RC Alice Chalmer. Super Duty, a 1952 truck just went through. Jerry Osner from Little Birch Repair. A lot of you remember Jerry from his days of teaching in Melrose. I'm guessing this is a hobby for the gentleman. A hobby to put these things together and be able to drive them through a parade. In the Melrose VF post. Vehicles in a parade route. Looking for the Stranger of Candy, you wouldn't know where we have. Beautiful truck coming through here. Waldeck Trucking? South Center. With Minnesota Bedding out of Melrose. Minnesota Bedding must be bedding plant. Guessing because it has a big picture of a sunflower, or they're making beds out of sunflower. I'm gonna go with bee plants. They have music, but you can't hear it from the front with that big truck roaring. But back here you can. Oh, buddy. got a few more things coming down the road here. We're in Greenwald today with the Barley Days Parade. We've got a full afternoon of things going on here. What are we at? We're almost at noon, so when the parade's over, they must have the music starting back here at... We'll go down to the grounds and take a look at that a little bit and get you guys some footage of that so you can see what Barley Days is all about here in Greenwald, Minnesota. Beautiful day today. Beautiful day. Let's see. Minnesota, which one? Minnesota National Bank. MN-Bank. And she has got her candy. And she has lots of it. Hi.
Hi.
Thank you. A fruity. A flavored fruity. Yeah, we mentioned the candy thing. That's, you get a lot of that coming through the parade. So you got a John Lee's Ford truck and Miss Sox Center right there in the back. Right there in the back, ladies. See what we have. We have another superhero float. Who are we here? Woody's and the blazing down here, and there's the superhero thing right there. And that. Is it it? Or I see some lights flashing down there. And I see something big. Is that turning this way or is that turning that way? No, it's coming this way. Well, we're gonna have a little break in the action here. Well, my cleanup crew is picking up the candy. There is lots of it around here. Lots of candy here at the Barley Days Parade here in Greenwald, Minnesota. If you're watching this on Facebook, we can catch the full video where we have the extra width and when we're turning with some of these more intricate floats. You can catch that on YouTube. Go to the hometownnews.biz website and you'll be able to catch it there and check it out once you'll be there. Or you can go and click like on our Facebook page so you get notifications when these live streams go up. You can actually set it so that you can get notifications of just our live streams, which is kind of cool. Because when the weather is getting kind of funky, we do showing you some clouds from different areas. Hinson, Amanda Hinson, coming through right there with the car. Yeah, we're still going back there. We've got more things coming through. I'm not sure. Gentleman's running through. He needs a little bullhorn. Primary coming up. Tuesday primary. Tuesday primary.
Okay, well, we can help you set up the coffee stall.
Getting into a little discussion about the primaries coming up and Trump, supporters of Trump. Not too political, but that's probably not a parade route discussion you want to be having if you're trying to make time through the parade route. Just saying. Just saying. There, can you go grab those, please, and make sure it's all cleaned up? And those. Okay, we got a, whose dump truck is this coming through? PJ's excavating out of Belgrade. Got it all prettied up and such. They have got a t-shirt launcher on that. North American's First Bank, something like that? I'm not sure. We'll find out more as we get here. But you're gonna hear that push from a t-shirt launcher up in a tree. Oh, I thought maybe they're gonna launch that one into the tree and it's gonna get stuck. For those wondering, it's a CO2 launcher, which means they throw it in there, they have a CO2 tank that holds a little bit of pressure, and they release it, and poof, it goes up in the air. They use them at Twins games. You've seen the backpack launcher. Oh, well, t-shirt, in that time, a couple of balls there, is a t-shirt being loaded. You can check that out here. It looks like it's got a range of about 50 feet. And that's about it. It's coming on the screen from the North American State Bank. Yeah. Old Reliable. So it's a trailer. Belgrade Co-op with a 1929 Model A coming through right there. We're getting to about an hour into our parade today. Just for kicks is next. The next little vehicle you're seeing coming onto the screen is one of the little ice fishing shanties that you can drive right out to the lake if you need to. It can float. Drive right out, lower it down to the looks like that's a lowering one. Lower it down to the ice, fish, go back up, start it up, drive off the ice. If you do it right, you probably wouldn't even need to get out of the shanty or get moved from your seat. You have to drill the holes, but you know what I mean. You know what I'm saying. Flipson Trucking is coming. See, now that's done right. Flipson Trucking, if you guys can see that as they're coming out of the screen, has a sign, big text, I can read it. Flipson Trucking gets my thumbs up for the day. So, well, there's been some cool floats, but for signage, Flipson Trucking is now my hero. They did it right. I can see that. I know. This live stream, and we'll do another little walk around live stream from down there. Okay, I gotta check my phone and see how much we have for battery life. We should be good, but we'll find out. But our last little, oh, that's right, there's a state plowing match coming up here just south of town next weekend. Yes, 2 miles south of Greenwald next weekend. National plowing match. 2 miles south, I'm guessing on number 4, August 11th and 12th. Okay, so we're gonna try to do this without taking the microphone off. I'm gonna try to get down here so I can see. So that's it for the parade. This is Bar of the Days Parade, Greenwald, Minnesota. Thank you for watching, wherever you're watching from, whichever camera you're watching from. We're going to head down to the grounds right now, so if you're watching this and you have nothing to do, you can hang out and we'll be back on, hopefully live in about 10 to 15 minutes. Otherwise, you can catch the videos and such on our Facebook page. You can catch them, you know, everything will be posted there so you guys can see and get the links. This is John Young from the Hometown News. We'll see you in a bit. Thank you much.